Just don't let me fall, Dad.
Never.
I, Edward Cullen, take you, Bella Swan, to love.
To cherish. As long as we both shall live.
Hey, it's Genevieve Lowe, your flick chick from Today newspaper. So Edward and Bella sitting in a tree, K-I-S-S-I-N-G. First comes love, then comes marriage, then comes the much hullabaloot supernatural lovemaking so passionate and dramatic that furniture gets broken and half-human, half-vampire babies get made. Welcome to part one of the big finale to the Twilight Saga film series. Based on the final book in Stephanie Meyer's wildly successful novels about broody teen vampires, super buff werewolves, and that one human girl that gets them going all gaga, Breaking Dawn has shrewdly followed the footsteps of Harry Potter and split its highly anticipated conclusion into two separate films.
Strong and fast growing.
It's crushing you from the inside out.
You did this.
I can't see Bella's future anymore.
We don't know what they've bred. We have to protect the tribe before it's too late.
You're the enemy now.
So what's there left to say about a film series that, despite a continual stream of horrendous reviews, has made billions of dollars, sparked frenzied fan mania, and launched the careers of Kristen Stewart, Robert Pattinson, and Taylor Lautner? I've never been a fan of the Twilight films. The first two were yawn-worthy, soap operatic melodramas that moved like a slug, the third only slightly picking up the pace and the laugh. So it stands to reason that this is truly the best of the lot. It mostly because it's directed by Oscar winner Bill Condon, who gave us Gods and Monsters and Dreamgirls, and the fact that something actually happens outside of angsty broods and swoony looks. The film does lag in the first half, but picks itself up in the second, where blood spills, a violently unsettling birth, and a vampire werewolf square off combine to whet fans' appetite for part two.
As long as we both shall live.
This is how I'll remember you.
Pink cheeks.
Sure, there are way too many groan-worthy lines and eye-rolling flimsy plot devices, but who are we kidding here? Critics really have no weight when it comes to films like this. The die-hard fans are going to love, devote, and adore. The haters are going to scorn, loathe, and abhor. And everyone else? Well, we'll just have to lie down till the feeling passes. Not quite two, not quite three bags of popcorn.